Okay, so I'm just about to score my learning styles inventory. I've already gone through and I've answered all the questions. I've given a 4 to the word that seems to, to my sense, correspond the closest to the way that I like to learn, or the way that learning has worked best for me, and a 1 to the one that is least. Sometimes they're really easy to figure out. Sometimes I have to kind of go, is it this one? Is it that one? It doesn't matter a whole bunch because there's a bunch of questions that'll come at it the same way, and so it'll sort of average out. So now I'm at the scoring part, and here at the bottom you'll see that the 4 columns are labeled C, E, R, O, A, C, and A, E for each of these 4 columns, and they have a series of numbers, and those numbers correspond to the different questions. And so I'm going to take the score from those questions. So for example, in this first column, the C, E column, I'm going to be looking at questions 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7, 8. And so then if I add those up, I get 17. In the RO column, I'm looking at questions 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I'll add up those numbers. And I also get 17. Here I'm looking at 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9. 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9. Quick math. And that's 21. And in this one, I'm looking at 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, that one's just an 8. Okay, so in this column I've got a 17, a 17, a 21, and an 8. So AC is my highest number, AE is my lowest number. And so then if I was to mark it on this little bullseye chart here, I get sort of a lopsided kite shape. There's my 8 there, there's my 21 there. So it tells me that I'm strongest in this hemisphere, this side of the equation. And the active experimentation part of learning is not where I gravitate towards, and so I need useful for me to know going forward that that may be something I want to work on, but that this is one my strength that I can rely on, and so those will be useful as we're going through and you're working your way through the spiral.